Alexa, turn on dining room light. Alexa, turn on kitchen light. In order to control this device with Alexa, I need to use this smart hob. But if you're looking for a way to control your lights without a smart hob, maybe this product is the solution. Thanks to the Home Depot Seeds program, we're going to be looking at the Globe Edison Smart Bulb. It uses just under 6 watts, puts out 500 lumen. It's a smart bulb, which if you don't know what that means, it means that you can control it via an app to turn it off, turn it on. In this case, we can change color temperature on it from 2000 all the way to 5000K. And if you have other smart controlling devices like Alexa, Hey Google, Siri, or SmartThings, they'll also be able to control this bulb. Of course, if you don't have one of those devices, then you can just use the Globe Suite application available for Android and Apple phones to control the bulb. And it'll also give you the ability to decide when it's coming on, going off, if you want to have warm light in the morning, bluer light towards the end of the day, if you wanted to come on while you're on vacation, lots of ability within an app. So let's open the box and take a look. First thing we see opening the box is instructions to download the app, Globe Suite, from the Apple Store or Google Play. Inside, there shouldn't be a whole lot. We have an Edison looking LED bulb with a standard US connector. Inside the box, you'll find the quick start guide and what looks like RF exposure compliance. With everything unboxed, we see the bulb measures from top to bottom about 4.5 inches. The globe itself is about 4 inches across, which makes it a fairly wide bulb. So now it's time to download the app. We simply go to our smartphone, type in the name, tell it to install. It downloads, we hit open. And the first thing we have to decide is whether we're registering or if we're going to use this as a guest. Advice, probably easier just to go through the whole registering step, which means remembering another password and providing your email. Do note that this only works with a 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi router. Once the bulb is installed in the fixture and power is applied, the bulb will start pulsing, indicating that it's ready to be received by your app so that you can control it. After about 30 frustrating minutes, you might be able to get the app to hook up and turn on the light. And that's with the lamp just being about 15 feet away from the router. And with a little bit more luck, you might actually be able to get your device, in my case, Alexa, to control the light. Alexa, turn on the buck room light. For this device to properly work, you're going to need a router that's close enough to the light so that you can work the Wi-Fi. Same applies to the device, Alexa in this case, that's controlling this light. Once you're paired to the router and to the bulb, first thing I notice is there's a bit of yellow and then white, and that's because the filaments themselves are yellow going across, and then up and down is white. So it mixes those four elements to get you the color balance you want. Unfortunately, because one side is just emitting more blue or more red, you kind of get that displayed, especially on this type of shade, where you can see the two colors as they're trying to be mixed. So I think that's just a fault of the Edison type bulb because it's not frosted. Things don't really get, the colors don't get to mix that well. With the ability to control the light with the built-in globe suite or the Alexa app, there's no longer the need to use the foot switch to operate this light. We just always leave it in the on mode and turn it off via one of the two app control devices. Finally, we get down to the pros and cons of this light. One, we like the fact that it uses the globe app to control temperature, dimness, when it's coming on and off. You can also use your smart voice device, like I have Alexa, to control it. Because it's LED, you know it's going to last a long time and not use much power. Things I don't like about it, you can probably see here. It's a little bluish on this side, a little warm on this side. The other thing that I found a little annoying last night was there was some flickering. It was very, very, very slight, but I did pick up on it. I don't see it today, so maybe it has to do with the bulb warming up, but it did catch my eye, and a light shouldn't do that. And probably the biggest con for me was the easy installation wasn't easy. It took multiple attempts and failures before I got this light to actually work with the app. Tying it to Alexa was much easier, but overall, probably almost half an hour to get this light to work correctly. Of course, once you finally get the apps working correctly, then you're done. You don't have to do it again. Should you have a power failure, the light will probably turn on when power is reestablished, but you can simply use your smart apps to tell it to go off, and there shouldn't be any need to reconfigure. I like all the other conveniences, but you buy a light because you need it to illuminate. And if it illuminates the wrong color temperature or multicolor temperatures, and that's not what you want, then maybe that isn't the product for you. So unfortunately, I can't really recommend this product. I think those are just shortcomings, and there are other products that do the same thing without a hub that may be better, and those are worth exploring. If you found this video illuminating, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, join the subscription team, and as always, thank you so much for watching.